It looks like you've all finished your do-nows and put your journals away. I'll look at them later. And right, I really want to see how big a list of genetic diseases you might have been able to come up with. I know some of you have seen family problems, right? Cancer. But just put your book away. I'll look at the list later. We have a lot to talk about right now because the genetics team has done some preparatory work, and I'm anxious to hear what they have to say and what you did as a result
of
their work.
Okay, Teresa, Dan, Kaisha,
right, come up front. Come up front. I want them to explain what you folks did. Right, right. I know everybody did it. They know, but just humor me. Go over what it was you had everybody do. Right, you made the sheet, and they all went okay, and they found somebody. Okay, you found some family. Yeah, sometimes it's a little hard to find a family with enough people that you can measure. Okay, class, tell me, were you able to find families to study? Good. Okay, where did you find them? Okay, your own family. And what if nobody wanted to participate? Okay, you found a family in the neighborhood. Okay,
good.
You only went to people you know. Good. I want you to be safe. Okay, so you all filled in a data sheet. Okay.
Okay, explain this to me. Right, everybody brought it with them. Yeah, this looks pretty clear. I can see that you have the trait and you've got next to it bushy, fine. Okay, but I'm looking over here. I can understand the F would be for somebody with fine. But what's the I? Oh, in between. In between. Okay, well, that makes sense. Yeah, now I see some other eyes. Okay. All right, in this case, right, that's a large nose. Okay, this family has everybody has a large nose and one person's kind of in between. Okay. Now, let's see, the female in the group and the male. And child one. Oh, no, that's father. Father, okay. I think you need something else on your chart. What is it that helps other people understand this? Right, the legend. Right, when you make this chart, if somebody were to come by later, we've talked about it in good science, somebody else should be able to replicate your experiment. Right, and I think you found some things out, right? You would probably redesign this instrument a little bit. But yeah, no, I think as long as you understand it, I would put some notes on it just so that if anybody else picked up your data, they would understand this. Okay, so everybody filled these in. Good. Okay, I can see you gave everybody a job. That's helpful. Yeah. Yeah, it's too bad we only have the one computer, but we can still do a lot. Yeah, I see how you put the spreadsheet in. Okay, yeah, no, it's clearer to me here. You don't have just F and M. Now I see it's not just female, male, it's father and mother. That's helpful. Okay, so you kind of transpose the data. Yeah, this looks well designed. Who put the yellow in? Right, that's conditional formatting. Very good. I didn't know you knew that. Yeah, that's helpful. And what's this number here? Right? Good. That's kind of the order you put the data in. Yeah, and I see, okay, right, this is the watching you team. Now, I know we have the data that you've collected, but I don't know if you know, but I've been collecting this data from everybody each year. Yeah, when you think about it, you all come up with pretty much the same design. And what we'll eventually do is pull them all together. Now, let's see. Okay, I'm going to bring my mouse over here. What does this mean? Okay, this is family number one. Teresa? Yeah, you're the reporter. Okay, I see you've got this child in here. So this particular family, the position of their eyebrows. Oh, I get it. I get why you named yourself the watching you. Yep, the position of their eyebrows. All of these people don't have connected eyebrows. Okay. Now I move down to the bottom because I know you all put the data in the same spreadsheet. You see this little tab? Let me click over to this other one, N size, and see what that means. Oh, okay. All right, I'm getting it. Okay, these are the nosy folk team. I see they're looking at big, medium, and small noses. Was that easy to figure out? Not always, right? Right, it's all a little bit relative. Okay, well, as long as you took good notes. Okay, I can see you used the same format as the other one. Oh, but you picked a different color. Okay, that's helpful. Anything that makes it easier to recognize the data differences will be useful. Now, I've kind of clicked back to the eyebrow people, but I'm going to show you. I know you've done some work with databases. This is actually a database, right? I've always told you, fill in all of the top of the row and all the way down the column. Good. So now you have a database. And if you click into the database, you can go up to data at the top. See if you can see that. Data at the top. And you can sort the data. And over here in this box, you can see that it's asking you what you want to sort by. Okay, I'm going to click the drop-down arrow. And I'm going to decide to sort this by the person. Let's see if the person in the family makes a difference. You think that should make a difference? Okay, I'm going to click by person. I'm going to click OK. And now, okay, I can see what all the child ones are like. I can see what all the child twos are like. Is that going to be useful? Think about it. Just because the computer can do it, is that going to help you understand the genetic structure? Okay, I'm not going to give you an answer. You're all going to break into your teams, take the data sheets, make your first pass there. Start to see if you are seeing any patterns. Right, you probably have, how many families altogether? 25 families. And you've got some with one children, but you've got one that has six children. That'll be helpful. Start looking to see if you find any patterns. Yeah, you have your worksheet. I put a few notes on it, but it's going to be up to you to figure out what your patterns are. And then come up here. I'll leave this open. You know how to use it. I showed you how to do the sorting. Have you ever done that before? Okay, some of you, those of you that took the Excel class, good. Well, you can teach some of the others if you have trouble. But if you are starting to develop a hypothesis, come up and see if the data can support it. Yeah, spreadsheets are very interactive. Right, Jamel, yes, you can make graphs too. You might want to see if a graph would help you. Okay, get into your teams, take your data sheets, start looking for patterns, and over the rest of the unit, we're going to be finding more ways to look at genetics, but let's start with the people right in our neighborhood.